Welcome. I am Sunil Kumar, Assistant Professor from Mahindra Institute of Technology. Today, we will see the topic about Mathematical Modeling of Single Degree of Freedom System. I hope that all of you well known about earthquake and its damages. The earthquake causes lot of life damages and also property damages. We cannot stop the earthquake, but we can avoid by some extent. We can avoid this earthquake by building the structure as earthquake resistant building. For this earthquake resistance design, we have to find how much amount of earthquake force acting on the building, so that to find this earthquake force, we have converted the real building into model. So this is the building frame, this is the foundation, this is the mass, this is the column. This column has stiffness K. I will tell what is called STOF. STOF means single degree of freedom system. This means only single coordinate is necessary to specify this mass. In this system, only one single mass is acting. So this is single degree of freedom system. Example, if you take this system, it has multiple masses. So this is first coordinate m1 and m2 and m3. There is more number of coordinates m1, m2, m3 is necessary to specify the mass. So this is multiple degree of freedom. In this system, only single mass is acting. So this is single degree of freedom system. In this derivation, we only derive single degree of freedom system. So we assume that the column has stiffness K. The column has stiffness K. Because the column is slender, so it has the property of stiffness. The column has only very less amount of mass, so the mass of the column is ignored. So the mass is acting at slab level only. So mass. The column is infinitely rigid, so it has no flexibility. It is fully rigid, so automatically it began no flexibility. Column is no flexibility. During construction, the column and the beam are built at the same time. So the column and the beam will act monolithically. So if the force is, the external forces act at slab level, the there is no rotation at the beam column joint. No rotation at beam column joint. So, for the derivation, we assume some parameters. The parameters involved in this derivation is M. M is the mass of the system. K is the stiffness of column. So K is the stiffness of column. And C is the damping coefficient. So, damping coefficient means it has the property to absorb the vibration. The example for dampers is shock absorbers in vehicles. F is the force. The force means the depth of force acting on system. Now we convert the real building frame into model. Model means lab model. So you can, this is the foundation. We transform this foundation as this model. The column is represented as spring because the spring has large number of stiffness. The mass is represented as body. The dampers is represented as the force is acting on the body. This body will move from its initial stage. So, for movement, we provide the rollers. Now, we convert this model into free body diagram. Free body diagram is nothing but we consider only the forces acting on the body. This is the body. The force is acting at this point. This force is resisted by mass of the body. To maintain this equilibrium of forces, this external force is resisted by mass Mx. Next, this force is resisted by damping force. Cx. And then this force is resisted by spring. Yes. by considering the equilibrium of forces, this forces is equal to this forces. So mx plus cx is damping force plus kx equal to external force. So this is the mass force. This is the damping force. This is the stiffness. This is the external force. So during the earthquake force is resisted by mass of the body, spring. Spring is nothing but column and then dampers. So the equation of single degree of freedom system is mx plus cx plus kx equal to 0 f of t.